I'm Shruti Pandey, and as a customer success specialist, I help the customers with the technical adoption and the onboarding with the main focus on DNA Center and SD Access, and hence save their time on solving their network challenges. In this video, I will demonstrate you how to discover your network with DNA Center, complete your wireless assurance configuration, and scale your assurance coverage. So, are you all ready? Then let's get started.
Now let us start with the discovery of a device. This is our DNA Center homepage, as you can see. Scroll over to this football menu over here and click on about to see the version we are on, 1.3.3.3.1. And now let us scroll down to discover a device. So go to tools menu here and click on discovery. You need to add discovery here, and on the left hand side you can see the various discoveries that have been done on the devices. And now on the right hand side we will create a new discovery. Let be given an option of a discovery. Since we are discovering a WLC, let me say a discovery of a WLC. And now here are the various discovery types that we have here. One is the CDP, where you have to mention the IP address of the neighbor and the CDP level. Then we have the IP address range, where you have to mention the from and the two IP addresses, and DNA Center will scan the list of IP addresses for the discovery. And then we have the LLDP, where again you can enter the IP address and the LLDP level as well. So let me go to IP address range and let me enter an IP address. So I'm entering the same IP address because I'll be discovering only one device here. Scrolling down, you can add the credentials here, the CLI credentials, the SNMP credentials and so on. And then when you're done adding them, click on discover. You have an option of discovering the device right now as well as later time, in which you can select the date and the time of discovery as well. So for now, let me select now and start the discovery process. As you see, this was quite fast. The discovery has been completed successfully. You see it is a success one, as you can see here, and the device shows discovered. Now let me go to the view inventory option here and let us see our device there. So now, well, let me select the filter of the device type, which is the WLCs, and this is a device that we just discovered. I will click on this checkbox here and then I'll go to actions and I will provision the device. Where will I first assign the device to a site? So this is the page where you can assign the device to a site. You have the serial number of the device and here you choose a site. As you see, we have various different sites here. Let me go to North America, USA, California, and San Jose. And let me select the SJC01 building here. I will save it and then I will assign it. As you see, the assignment has been successfully completed and you can see the device is now reachable. And also you can see the image version and the uptime of the device as well. So now let us see how do we change the network profile telemetry of the WLC. This is our DNA Center homepage. Here we go onto the tools menu and we click the network telemetry. In the network telemetry page that you see here, we have our site view and we have a profile view. In a profile view, we have an option of creating and editing different profiles and as well as deleting them. So let me show you how would we add a profile here. You need to give a profile name, let it be demo. And also we need to enable some capabilities. Let me check the syslog box. So if we check the syslog box, it'll ask you for a severity level. It can be informational, errors, warnings, notifications. And also you have an option of choosing the application visibility. You save this profile, and that's how easy it is to create a profile. Also, when you go to the site view, you're able to see the different devices and the different sites and which are the profiles that they have on their sites. So this was about network telemetry.
Now, let us go over to our assurance dashboard and see various other information respective to our client health. So this is our DNA Center homepage. We go to the assurance and click here. And here, this is the main overall health dashboard that you see with the network devices on the left and the wired clients and the wireless clients on the right. As you can see, we have an information on the healthy, 90% healthy wireless clients and also 98% healthy wired clients. So here in the dashboards, when you go to health and you choose client health, this is where the client dashboards open. And this is a graph where if you hover over it at one point, you will see the healthy percentage of the clients of wireless and the wired at that particular time. So this is at 4:10 p.m. and this is at 7:35 p.m. You just need to hover over this graph. And not only this, you also have an option to choose the particular time of which you want to see the graph for. You can choose it for 7 days, you can choose it for 3 hours, and also you can just put a start date and an end date. When I scroll down, it also shows the wireless clients, which are total 250 and are active are 249, out of which it shows 15 are not onboarded with authentication issues and some have fair connectivity. And when you go down, you also see the client onboarding times as well, with the wired with the blue one and the wireless with the pink one. And on the right side, you have the connectivity RSSI, also the connectivity signal to light ratio for the client counts. And when you scroll down, you see the client roaming times as well and the client count for SSID also. Like COP SSID has 18 clients, another one has 21, and another SSID has like 211 clients. Also, when you scroll down, you are able to see all the client devices that are connected in your network. You have an option to choose wireless and wired here. Also, you can choose the health where you can choose all or probably poor health and click apply here. You will get all the clients that have poor health in your network right now. And not only that, you also have an option of choosing the data, where you can choose the onboarding time, the association, and so on. Scrolling down, we also have a visualization of the client counts per band. Like in the 5 GHz band, we have like 216 clients, while in the 2.4 GHz, we have 34 clients. And the most important one, the client data rate, where you can see the client count and the data rate that they have been having in the network. So this was all about the discovery and the wireless assurance dashboards. Well, it was simple, right? I hope you really liked it and found some great and useful tips for your wireless assurance deployment. Also, do check out the other videos and the courses that I recommend for you in the description below. So as of now, stay safe and bye-bye.